Today we are going to start our lecture number 16. In this lecture, we are going to study helix on cylinder and helix on cone. First, we will study the helix on cylinder. Now, on helix on cylinder, the question will be draw a helix of 1 revolution to cylinder of diameter 40 mm and length 70 mm. That means here we have one cylinder given whose diameter is 40 mm and its length or height is 70 mm. Now, if you want to draw a helix on a cylinder, so for that purpose we have to draw the front view and top view of the cylinder. So I will start drawing. I will draw the XY line. I will draw the circle in top view, because in top view cylinder look like circle, and in front view it will look like rectangle. Now divide this circle into 8 equal parts. First is I will draw horizontal, then vertical, then draw a line at a 45 degree, again draw 45 degree, name the point 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, take the projections. Now I have completed the top view, now I will start the front view. In front view, helix cylinder is look like a rectangle, so we have started drawing the rectangle. So what is the height of this rectangle? Its height is 70 mm. Its height is 70 mm. Transfer all the projections of the generator. Now, next, divide this height into 8 equal parts. Why? Because we have divided circle into 8 equal parts, and we have to draw a helix on a cylinder for 1 revolution. 1 revolution, that means when we mount a thread to this one point, again it will come to the same point. So if you want the thread to here at this bottom, it will take revolution like this and it will go to the back side, again it will come to the top portion. So that will be the helix on a cylinder. So we have to divide this height into 8 equal parts. So I will draw 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th. Then join 8 point line and this, and draw parallel line to this. So this cylinder is divided into 8 equal parts. Next is we have to draw the horizontal lines from each point. So I have drawn the horizontal line from each point. After that, the here give the name 1-2-3-4-5-6-7-8, and this is a 9th, or you can say 1-. Next, 1 and 1-, intersection is this point. Mark it here, 1 point. Then 2 and 2-, intersection point is this. 3 and 3-, intersection point is 3. This is P3. So 4 and 4-, intersection point, here we get the P4. Here we get P5. Similarly, 6- horizontal line and 6- projector generator, we get the point 6, P6. And here 7- and this 7, we get the P7. Similarly, we get the P8 and P9. After that, name this point P1, P2, P3. P5, P6, P7, P8, P9. Then draw the helix. Now here I have drawn, which is passing through this helix, which is passing through point P1, P2, P3, P4, P5. Again I have to draw the remaining. Now this is dotted line. Why? Because when we round a thread to this, I will round a thread to this like this. So it will move backward side. So in front it is not feasible. That's why half portion is dotted. Now next, give the dimension to cylinder. Again give the diameter. Here radius is 20 mm. Next, give the name to the curvature, that is helix. Next problem is draw a helix of 1.5 revolution to a cylinder of diameter 40 mm and length or height is 100 mm. So here, that means we have given the cylinder diameter 40 mm, height is 100 mm. So I will draw the its top view. Top view cylinder look like circle. Then divide this cylinder into 8 equal parts. Then take the projections of the generators. Then what is the, give the name 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 9, 10, 11, again here it is 12. Now, and this is 30. then give the dimension to this circle, then we will draw the that cylinder that is look like a rectangle in front view. So I have drawn the rectangle of this diameter 40 mm and length is 100 mm. Now divide this rectangular height into 12 parts. Why? Because we have to complete the one revolution of the cylinder plus half revolution, that is 1.5 revolution. So this thread will be round to the cylinder, like from the bottom, this like first this is one revolution and remaining half will be like this will be the part. Now first we will divide this in cylinder into a height into a 12 equal parts. So I have started marking from this point 1 2 3 4 5 6 up to 12, then draw parallel lines from 12 to this point, join this line and draw parallel line to each point. So this cylinder is divided into 12 equal parts. Now draw the generators. Okay, these are the generators of the cylinder. Then draw horizontal lines from each point. Then give the naming to these points. Give the dimension. Again, mark the point. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to 12 and last is the 13. Now intersection of 1 and 1 dash, this is the point 2 and 2 dash horizontal line, this is the P2 point 3 and this is horizontal 3 dash, this is P3 4 and horizontal line, this point is P4 5, so this is P5, P6, P7, P8, P9, so this is one revolution. This is the remaining half revolution. So if you see here 10 dash and this is a 10, so it's this is point P10, P11, this is point P11, so this is point P12, so this is 12 dash horizontal line and this is the 12th generator. Then again 13 at the same point. Then give the name to these points. Again start drawing the curve. So here I have drawn this curve with the help of three hands. Okay, so this when it is front, so this portion is visible. When thread goes to the back side of the cylinder, so it will be dotted. Again when it comes to the front side, so it will again visible. So in this way we have completed this problem. So give the name to the curvature, that is helix. Now next, in this problem we have to draw a helix on a cone for one revolution. Okay, here we have given the diameter of the cone is 40 mm and its length is 70 mm or height. So for that purpose we have to draw the front view and top view of a cone. In cone, in top view look like a circle, in front view it is look like a triangle. So here I have drawn the top view, then I will start dividing this top view of circle into 8 equal parts. Give the name to each one. Give the name to each point 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, then transfer the projections. Now I have drawn the triangle for front view. What is the height of this? Its height is 70 mm, this height. Then these are the generators. Draw the generator of the cone. Now next, again we have to divide this height into 8 equal parts. So I have divided the draw inclined line at a 30 degree or at an acute angle. Then start divide this line into 8 equal parts. Then transfer this all the distances horizontal line, all the points on the horizontal line. So here we get the point. Now this is first, second dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, 6 dash, 7 dash, 8 dash and last is 9 dash. Now mark the point 1 1 dash, this is P1, so 2 2 dash, this is P2, this is P3, this is P4 and this is yahan pe P5 chahiye, P5, P6, P7, P8 and P9. Okay. Now we get the each point. Now next is draw the curvature. So I have draw the curve P1, P2, P4, P5, then P7, P8, and P9. Next, now here this curvature will be dotted because thread will be go on the back. P2, P3, P4, P5, P6, P7, P8, P9. Many students think that, sir, how I get these points? So see, this is the second generator. Okay, this is generator 2. So I am matching this generator with the horizontal line 2 dash. This is P2. This is third generator, vertical, and this is horizontal line P3. Similarly, this is fourth generator. So this is 4. So it is matching with the line 4 dash. So intersection of this fourth generator, this is fifth, again it will be the sixth, again 7, and this is 8. Now you can see this 8 generator and 8 generator, 8 that horizontal line, we get this P8 point. Similarly, we get the P9. Point is again 1 dash generator, which is matched with the 1 dash generator. After that, we have to draw the horizontal. After that, we have to draw the curve with the help of the freehand curve. You have to draw. So up to this P5, it is visible. After that, P6, P7, P8, it is not visible. Now here we have easily drawn the front view. Now for top view, we have to transfer the point. Now see how we are going to transfer. Now here, from this point, one point you can easily get here, P1 point, but second point here we have to transfer this point. So we can transfer this point, so here you get the P2 point. Similarly, P3 point, you have to, this P3 point you cannot take directly here, because this point is on the vertical generator. So if you see from the front, you look like this line is a perpendicular, but it is inclined. This from apex, this generator is inclined, though it is look like perpendicular in front view. So for that purpose, we have to transfer P3 point on this 3 dash line. So from this slant edge, we have to transfer the point at the horizontal plane. After that, we have to rotate it like this. So here we get the P3 point. For P4, you can directly take projection 4, P4 and 4th generator. Here, these are the generators. Now 5, again this P5 point and 5th generator. This is also generator. This is apex. This point is apex, and this is apex to this 5, which is one generator. Similarly, P6, but P7 is also same on the vertical line. So here, for that purpose also, we have to take the projections. We have to transfer that to the bottom. Here again we have to rotate it, so we will get this curve. Mark this point in top view and you have to draw the freehand curve. Here if you see, I have done this procedure for point number P3 and P7. If you see the procedure, what I have done, the procedure from P3, I will transfer that point up to incline line. Yaha pe ek incline rahega, up to that incline line I have to transfer that. Then I will transfer that projections downward, and after that, this as the center, I will draw one, rotate the arc, and it will intersect here. So P3, and here is also P3 point. So front view and top view of a point always lie on the same projector. So this is the main concept. Similarly, for P7, we have to take here on incline, this generator, slant generator, slant edge. After that, we have to transfer it, and we have to this much as a distance in compass, this as a center, rotate an arc here. So we will get the another point, that is P7. So in this way, we can draw the helix on a cone. This is very simple process. Just you draw, try to draw the front view. After that, you try to draw the top view. Now, question for homework. You have to solve this question for homework. Draw a helix of 1 revolution to a cylinder of diameter 40 mm and length is 80 mm. Again, draw a helix of 1.5 revolution to a cylinder diameter 40 mm and length 90 mm. Again, the last question is draw a helix of 1 revolution on a cone of diameter 40 mm and length is 70 mm. Now, you cannot believe in God until you believe in yourself. Thank you.